Oh my gosh. So desperate. So desperate. Just a desperate little doggy here. Desperate. Oh my gosh, then. This little dog. She's like, please, please. All I want is to come in the hot tub. Is that really what you want, buddy? Come here. Oh, she really wants in the hot tub today. Hot tub doggy. Desperate doggies. They'll do anything for attention. Right? She'll show those nips. Desperate. Desperate little bitch. That's all she wants. That wasn't enough. This doggy. Look at her. Look at her. Oh my gosh, then. No. No. She's trying a little too hard here. No. I'm drowning. What happens then? What if I go under, huh? What are you gonna do then, huh? Huh? What if I go under? Oh no, I'm going down. Oh no, you can't see me. Can't see me. Blah, 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 blah. She doesn't know what to do. Oh my god, what do I do with this dog? Zinny. Hey. You're okay. You're okay, buddy. She's just having a tantrum over here. Do you see this dog? Holy. Holy hell. Tantrum doggy. The best I can do for you. You can sit and chill by me if that's really what you want. Okay? She was losing her shit. Losing her little chihuahua brain. Okay. Let's go in here. Mm-hmm. What's going on, guys and gals? How's it going? Are you all just entertained watching this nonsense? Right. Do you want to swim? What do you want? What do you want? Staring contest? Hi there, Prime. It was alright. Just had some tuna and crackers, you know? Doesn't get much more basic and simple than that. She was throwing a fit, if you guys didn't see. She was just throwing a fit that she couldn't be in here, so I let her in. Also, Prime Alexander told me that he built some. I haven't looked it out. He said he built a big swamp base, though, apparently, that he's very proud of and wants people to use. Hey, guys. She just, I don't know what she's doing. This is what she wants, though. But as soon as I put her back down, she's like, throws a fit that she's not in here, so. She's happy, I guess. Are you really happy doing this, Zinni? I can't tell. Yeah, you do have some competition. Are you happy? Are you happy? If only you could speak. Tell me. Tell me what you want, little doggy. I don't know. Do you want to swim? Do you want a little chihuahua bikini and be a hot tub streamer too? Is that what you want? I'm sure they make chihuahua bikinis. Yeah, could find you one. Come cuddle me. I mean, yeah, I can't really just hold her though. So her choices are she gets to chill there or she can chill elsewhere. She can't just be held the whole time though. That's not gonna work. Hi there, Elvish Raptor. Hi, Boxcock. Jump to me. Swim to me. We'll see if she'll do it. You gonna come? I don't think she's gonna do that. But she's welcome to if she wants to. Thinking about it? She's thinking about it. I know you actually like swimming. Okay. Okay. That's enough of that, little baby. Not sure how long you'll be here since it's past midnight, but thanks, Epic Potato. Oh, you're right. Box Air Prime. Hi there, Yarrow Flower. Thanks. There, she wants back again. Nope. How long have I streamed? Not very long. Boxcock. Okay. Box. There we go. There we go. Boxcock. her name's Zinny. Oh my gosh, like he's back again. She's just going all over the place. What do you want, dog? Yeah, no, I've only been streaming. I'm new to streaming. She does like to swim. Do you wanna? Here. Maybe she needs to go out. Go on, little doggy. Get along. I just left my door open so she can let herself back in. Stellar in black. I like black too. Black's my favorite color. Favorite color. Black. I think it goes with the blonde well too. Does she like to swim? Sometimes. Depends on her mood. Last time I took her on the river, she just jumped out and went for a swim. Your cat. Okay, it's if a drop of water falls in them. Yep, Zinny likes it. She's a little swimming dog. Kinda. Donut duck? No. Donut duck's gonna hang out with me here. Yep, Strat Studio, I'm back. Black and dark blue. I don't like those two colors together, but in general, I like both those colors. I think blue and black don't go together very well, personally. But I wear dark blue, I just don't wear it with black. I need to change the size of my chat right here. A little bit bigger. There we go. Donut duck. Your sprinkly buddy. That's right. Sprinkles. Sprinkly buddy. Good old donut duck. You like it in contrast with my suit. I do kind of like the blonde when it's with black. The other colors, I'm not as sure about, but you wear black. Kind of like it. So. What should we do tonight, guys? How long did I change my color? I did. I did it while I was banned on a YouTube stream. I did a live. Zinny! Nice. She's back in. We should play a game or something. Hi, Zinny. Come here. She's back. Just gonna shut my door. And grab one of these. I'm just gonna get this so I'm prepared. But having a controller here and everything, just in case. Play a game or something. I mean, yeah. Which game, though? These buttons. Time. How do I do it? There we go. Did it. Got him. Okay. Don't do that. Which game would it be in? I don't know about two truths, one lie. I mean, people can make gaming and hot tub streams go together however they like, right? Everyone who's streaming, they're doing it from a PC, so just a matter of using that PC for gaming too. Mine's right here, you know, in front of me. That's how I'm able to do things and move stuff and whatnot. So, you know, I just start up the game and change my Streamlabs studio settings so that you can see it, move things around, all that. I gained quite a bit from my hot tub and on my YouTube streams. Played a decent amount of Valheim. But I played Blasphemous too. I could play whatever though. What was there? There was the ones, the suggestions I saw. There's a few that I liked. Who's in Valheim? Oh, he is. Maddie's been playing Valheim so much, damn. She's not on my server. I wonder how many hours I've got on Valheim. Oh, 53 hours. I've got a lot. 53 hours on Valheim that I've put in basically. Like the past week. A lot of Valheim. You got 500 hours on there? Wow, you do 473, not quite 500. Got some work to do. I mean, the whole idea, though, is trying to do some stuff that's different, right? Different stuff. Different things. So my days often consist of two. My thoughts, what I need to do. Mostly what I think about, that's mostly what my days are. What do I need to do better? My future. Where am I going? What am I doing? Tomorrow's Thursday. I think tomorrow I'll definitely do a gaming stream. Something. I'm gonna have to think on it, which one it'll be, but I'll do it like from my PC so I can play a more serious one. Could do Valheim. I wouldn't mind getting more people on the server and joining on there too. That could be fun. Cause it does have a 25 person cap, so a lot of people can definitely play on there. Plus, I love Valheim. I'm so addicted to it. You play WoW? Damn. Dailies, ugh. I so don't miss having to do dailies in any game. Never been a fan. It's kind of like such a... I don't like dailies. It's a good time waster. That's fair. It's fair. Just, yeah. I hate, because I hate missing anything. Like, whenever there's dailies, it makes me feel really overly compelled to never miss any. And then it becomes just like work and stressful and all that, and I don't like that. When I feel like, oh, I can't do this with people or whatever, like, I haven't done this, I'm gonna have to go home, I'm gonna have to beat my dailies first, because gotta do that. Too often does it impact my life in very negative ways. You want this mount, that's fair. World of Warcraft in general though is just garbage, right? Don't miss it at all. Way too many hours spent on there. Time wasted. Like, just imagine all that time I'd spent playing WoW, I'd learned an instrument or something. Like, there was some value. There was some value I got out of WoW. A lot. Early on, hardcore, I learned a lot about politics, socializing, interacting with people. A lot of, because I was playing at a very, very high level, and one of the, if not the top guild in the world, and there's a lot of really smart people in there and everything. It's an interesting experience, but where I learned a lot as a young kid doing that, and from there though. Beyond that experience, I didn't gain it that much. Like, there was value there, but after that, it was more just way to deal with depression, I guess. Something to do. Something that dominated my life way too much, too. Rather than it's hard because I didn't have great options either. It's like, it's better that I could socialize there, I guess, than nowhere. But still, it's a tricky area, I guess. WoW and MMOs and that stuff, like, it's better than nothing, but it's certainly not a replacement for actually interacting with people and the world in a more substantial manner. EverQuest was definitely before my time, but I did play EverQuest too. Only when they released the PvP servers. They released the PvP servers on EverQuest 2 and I played it then. But yeah. Same idea, right? Same stuff. MMOs in general. That's why I vowed never to play an MMO again. That was my sort of promise to myself, you know? Never gonna never gonna touch them again because they are problematic. She's back. Look who's back again. Yeah. Time sinks is what they are. Basically, yeah. Oh my gosh. Enough. Be gone with you. Foul winch. Foul winch. Shoo. Yep. Adult beverage. Yep, that's my dog. Do I do this for a living? Yeah. Don't grind or anything. One character. And then do older raids that you can solo. Well, that's one way you can play it, I guess. Sounds like the way my ex played it, which is so never been an option for me. If I play a game, especially an MMO, I've gotta be at the top. I've gotta be the best. I've gotta min-max everything. Total style of playing is just as fast as most efficiently best as possible. Everything. But that's my personality in general, though. What is it, you know, type A, I guess, or I think it's a little too oversimplified to try and do just two personality types, but definitely more in that style. Pronouns are she, her. Oh, wow, still got little bumps there. Oh my gosh, this dog. She's never been like this. Never. Really desperate. Be gone. I have no idea who Charlotte Flair is. Don't mind grinding for stuff. But you'll do it if you have friends that play. Spare. Doesn't have his hips. I definitely don't have hips. No hips here. Neither does my mom though. It runs in the family. No hips. I know you didn't see me, but I said I don't have hips. It's not really a debatable fact. There's not. No, hips here. Yeah. It is what it is, right? Hips is always what I wanted more than anything, too. That was like, hips over everything is what I always wanted. Never happened though. Don't always get what we want, right? You say I have boobies. I can have yours. Oh yeah. I'll take them. I'll take everyone's hips. Give them all. Oh, I have hips out to here. I've got a figure, right? It's definitely a figure. Oh my gosh, this dog is being ridiculous right now. What you don't have in hips, you make up for in personality. It's a nice sentiment. My dog is tripping me out right now. This is turning into an issue. I need to like go give her a bone or something. She's never done this before. I don't know why she's doing it. Okay, I am gonna like give her a bone or something because this dog's being crazy. Come on, Zen. She's back. Go. Get your bone, dog. Some kind of bone dog. Okay, I didn't allow that because let me see. She wants to swim with me and Donut Duck. I don't know if she does. She maybe just thinks she does or something. Bitches, you'll mod for me? Yeah, sure. Yeah, no, you can definitely be a mod prime. Let's see if I got those. Oops. Where we go? I think I did it. There we go. Bitches need the bone sometimes. There we go. Got that bone. Bussy? I don't even know what that is. Dance, please. How about you dance? You dance for me. Cam to cam. Show me that dancing. You. Dance for me, monkey. There we go. Do I have TikTok? Yeah. I do have a TikTok. Somehow. Okay. Where is my... There we go. It's on there. I don't know what a dusty is. So, you're asking about my genitalia, though. My profile explains it. Yeah. There you go. Sometimes people let's see here.
Delicious. But then what happened?
Looking at that. Okay. What do I got in here? Checking this out. Wait, oh, I didn't open my recent events. It needs to be open. Of course it's live. Who doesn't do live? Good stuff. Who is this person? Gotta check some of this stuff out. None of that. Okay. Are you trans? Yeah. my guidelines for moderating are hard to explain. You'd have to. I'll add you to my Discord. It's discussed there in the channel. It's mostly just feeling it out, I guess. Seeing what I do, how I feel about things. Okay, this is ridiculous. Did well on your interview today. Would you say so yourself? Yeah? You liked it? You liked that today? Glad. Yeah, in general, don't worry too much about banning people. You just time out. Or delete if you're unsure. Bans are usually for people who are repeat offenders or just like blatant homophobia. Mostly people who are irredeemable. That's why my ban requests are always absurd and no one ever gets unbanned from my channel because If they get banned, they're really fucked up. You are hot to stream together. Should have a spinny wheel shots. I wouldn't mind having a little wheel. I can pull up a wheel right now. You can save your alibi. I already know you lie. Pretty sure I have a wheel. Oh, no, don't even try. There it is. Watch the flame in me ignite. You didn't wanna walk the plank. But the ready or not. Wow, yeah. I don't even. There's a wheel. Fill out and spin. How do I spin it? Let's see. There we go. I could spin it. No idea what the different things would be, but I could do it. Seems like you can usually tell the usernames. That's pretty racist, Frank. pretty racist. Pretty racist. Never judge a book by its cover. I thought you knew better than that. Now what do we do with it? Yeah. I mean, what should go on there? I don't know. Anything. Possibilities are endless. Categories. There's a donut category. How's there a donut category? I'll just modify that one to... I put don't duck. Donut duck. Here we go. Oh my gosh, why is it, it's not letting me. Well, let me add donut duck. Look at this. Okay. There it is. It's all dancing. No donut duck action. Lame. Do you ever ride donut duck? I have before, I guess. I've ridden Donut Duck before. He's a good boy. Good Donut Duck. Where are you going, Donut Duck? Can you ask a very stupid question? I don't know, maybe. I mean, you can ask it. Everyone's always free to ask whatever they want. Will you get banned? Will there be consequences for actions? Always a possibility. That's just the world we live in, right? You do whatever you want. You may have to pay the price. I think in general, I hate that question. Whenever anyone says, can I ask a question? It's like, you just did. You just asked a question. So obviously, yes, you can ask questions. And if you're gonna ask a question, just ask a question. just how I feel on it. It's like such a waste of space. Basically, there's nothing I hate more than inefficiency, and asking if you can ask a question is like one of those, you know? The same as when people just send you, like, hey, what's up? How you doing? It's like, you fucking kidding me? Get to the point. You got something to say? Say it. Or don't say it. That's a good wheel, just dancing, I know, right? That's not what I intended, but that's how the wheel turned out. They're all just dancing. Just dance. Thanks, Prince Adam. You say you're trans? What do you mean? That means that I was born male? That's what it means? Play stupid games, win stupid prizes is a quote that comes to mind, yeah? That's right there, too. It's up there. It's like... huh. Ask your questions. I have AMA tagged in my thing. I answer questions regularly. I mean, ask your question. If you're gonna ask a question, don't ask if you can ask a question, though. At that point, you make me want to say no. No, you can't. That is ridiculous. I'm looking at this. How is that recommended higher to me? Than my own stream? When I look at this list, what's perplexing to me is how my own stream is so far down on my own recommendations. Like, how is that possible? How am I, like, pages down? As my own recommended for me? Alright, let's see here. I'm beauty poo. It's what you do. I don't know about that. Hi there, Shrek lover. Your question was how? How what? How is not a question. Let's see. So you were born male. So does that mean that you have a dick? Because you are really beautiful as a girl, but did you like get it cut off and made into a vagina? I have a really hard time understanding the whole trans thing in general. Yes. I did. I was born with a penis, and I had surgery to make it into a vagina. It's a complicated process in surgery and everything, but yes, now it is a vagina. can mean you aren't super into yourself if you're not your own top recommendation. I mean, it means something, right? Obviously, what I'm insinuating with it is it's Twitch trying to lower my visibility, because this was never the case before. I was always near the top of my own recommended streamers. And now I'm by, there's no one, like, you have to go up like 15 streamers before you can find anyone with more viewers than me. So, definitely tells me I'm, shadow banned, you know, and it's, annoying to deal with. Because I don't know if it's temporary, it's fine, but I have no idea. That's the problem. There's no information on it. Does it feel like the real thing? Or are you able to have kids? Yeah. I am able to have kids in a complicated way. I could carry my own biological child with my sperm that's frozen, with a uterus transplant and a donor egg. I could carry my own biological child, yes. So it is possible. And I could also just have a surrogate as well to have my own biological child. Both those are possible when we are talking about, because when people are asking about kids, they're obviously asking about biological children. Hi there, Andreas. What's up? Why did the sperm cross the road? Because you put the wrong sock on this morning. Nice. Crusty socks here, crusty socks there. Key and Peele sketch, pretty good one. That is super complicated to understand, is it? I think you're really trying to overthink it and nitpick it, because it's not that complicated. Born male, identify as female. It's that simple. Live my life as female, that's what makes me happy. Anything else is details, you know? There's details to everything, but the rest is all details. It's really, really is that simple. Born male, now female. Don't overthink it. Don't make it, I am a female. Don't really need it to be like, if you can't handle the deep dive into all the science and everything else behind it, you know? Look at it in the simple terms, because really, it doesn't need to be that more complicated. Huh. how frequent is the uterine transplants? Is that a recent thing? Yeah. It's pretty recent. Shadow banning is not a conspiracy theory. Shadow banning is like a well-known thing that happens all the time. You can even, on a lot of platforms, you can even type in URLs and check whether or not you're shadow banned. Like there's a way to check whether or not you're shadow banned on Twitter. I think it's shadowban.eu. Let's see. Yep, shadowban.eu. You can go on there and check whether or not you're shadow banned, because it's such a frequent practice. It is a practice that has existed as long as the internet has existed. Always has, always will, until we decide to, legislate against it. Really, there's not many other options. Because it's a shady practice to do. Because the problem with that is it lacks transparency. It's dishonest. And that's fucked up. You're misleading people by shadow banning. Like, either you're gonna let your content be controlled by an algorithm and do that like you pretend to do, and let that be the case, and not jump in and artificially bump or fuck people over based on the whims of your executive council, you know, your board or your moderators or whatever. Like, it's either you can do that, or you need to let people know what you're doing. Talking to you so far, I can tell that you're a really beautiful person. I was going to marry born male to female in my life. Thank you. Anne is an amazing streamer. I love her stream because she tries to educate people. But there are some that don't understand. It's true. Wondering, what's my name? I mean, it's Anne. My name is Anne. Born 2 blocks apart. I'm sorry I stole your car. But in my defense, yeah, I was full of innocence. Thanks. Hornet, Lars. But now the world has changed. Hey there. First love got engaged. Oh, how much I hope that one day we would elope and the rest would be his story. Well, thanks, your own image. Before we move off from affiliate? Probably never. Yeah. Cornet Lars? Thank you. Just read about shadow banning. They rely on the recipient to give up. Yeah, no, that's a bench, essentially what they go for. Who shadow banning is, they're just trying to get people to give up rather than having to outright ban them. So it's pretty disheartening, I guess, to see have a shadow ban in general, you know? Because rather than it was better press and PR for Twitch to unban me, but then to shadow ban me, it's very... solves all their problems, right? It's like, hey, can't say that we just unfairly banned someone anymore, but we're just gonna make it so we... like shatter their amount of exposure and everything like that, so you can't succeed. So you can't, it's way harder to prove, it's like much less of a news story, you know, a shadow ban, like it's doesn't make headlines like a full out ban does. So, you know, very typical of companies in general to do this. So happens all the time. You are noticing you weren't getting notifications anymore? Really? Wow, that's big if you did, but... yeah. It makes it... kind of. Timeout's more like a temporary ban. So not quite the same. Shadow bans are far more, it's also public, it's, I don't think that's a good analogy, you know? Because there's no way to test your shadow banned and all that stuff, so. Doesn't alert when I start a stream, really? I had no idea that was the case. I haven't heard that one. But... is that really true? No one gets alerts anymore when I start a stream? Is that really true? Because that's something that's provable. Like, anything you guys can give me that's, like, 100% provable, like, that is. That absolutely is. That's something that's very easily provable, but the difference is, look, you go down my recommended viewers list on everything, and I'm by people with 8 viewers. You know? I am by people with 8 8 8 8 6 6 6 5 5 5 9. Like, that's, those are the people that I'm by on my own list. You know, I'm that is pretty fucking obvious. What's going on doesn't take a genius to figure out that I'm being pushed down, right? My visibility is being limited artificially because it's never been like this before. And that's what shadow banning is. It's subtle. It's not something that you often can easily prove because it's something they, you know, people can still find you. You're still there. Everything is just a matter of limiting as much as possible. Your phone got the alerts? Okay. Potato. You didn't get the alert on your phone? You'll shoot. It's my IG. All my, I'm anatomics on all them. You can do socials too to find them all. They're there. Wasn't here at the start. Can't verify if any notifications. That's fair. They did not explain anything. For all I know, this is permanent. I don't really know. Which sucks. It sucks because I'm trying to plan my future and everything, figure out what I'm doing, and it's like I have a lot going on in my life and just trying to figure things out. It's, I'm permanently shadow banned, you know? My future obviously can't be with Twitch. I'll never be able to succeed shadow banned, so that's, just not a fan of it. Not a fan of it. Feels very unfair still. Unfair treatment, right? You just hopped in. You did not get a notification either, Onyx? Did you usually get notifications from me when I was streaming? Sad. Twitch acts woke and does shit like this. I mean, that's why they unbanned me, right? Is because there was enough bad press around it for them to feel compelled to unban. But this shadow banning thing is, in a way, just as bad, if not worse even, because at that point, it's being dishonest, right? Like, they are just being dishonest, and that feels like they're fucking, like, I never expected to get unbanned on Twitch, and like, I was planning things in the future around that pretense, and that's fair, at least, right? I guess in the sense that, like, at least I know what's up. And this just feels like dishonest, which I don't like. Because now I don't know.
I hope you can find an alternative. Most of their competition died, or in the case of Mix, sold to Facebook.
Thank you. Post-humanist potato. Apparently I need to turn off my fucking PC in there. Echoing. You don't want a dog pile, but you didn't get a notification from me either? Damn. Thank you. Jaden. And the last notification you got was last night at 7 p.m. Yeah, guys. So, anyways, those are my issues. Like, I just don't know how to deal with this, I guess. How to plan things out, if my exposure is limited. Like, I would love if I could get some clarification. Some clarification would be awesome. If I could just know it's temporary, permanent, like, then I can at least act accordingly. They would never do that, of course. That misses the entire point of a shadow ban. The entire point of a shadow ban is to avoid controversy, right? All these companies do it. And so Twitch is the ultimate. They're the OG. They are the ultimate, like, silent on everything. They want to avoid controversy. They want to avoid that at all times, any sort of discussion. So they won't comment on bans. They won't do any of that sort of stuff. And so if anyone was going to shadow ban, like, obviously it's Twitch, right? What better platform than to have a motive for that than Twitch? They all do it. Don't get me wrong, every platform does this. But for anyone who doesn't think Twitch is doing it, I guess, like, absolutely they're doing it. They all are. Every platform's doing it. And I can tell when I have to go down so far down the list. So far. I mean, it says 58 now on here. Everyone by me is 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 7, 6, 6. Like, come on. Especially when every single stream before I was banned, you know, they were all at least 110 average. I would get over 100 within 10 minutes of starting my stream. Every night I would be over 100 viewers. So, clearly, differences. You like that mouse key too? The video on control. Glad that helped. Just to tell you, all the people here that follow you on a daily basis, I think you're amazing. I think what you're doing are groundbreaking. Thanks. I appreciate that. I need to grab another drink. But yeah, said my covered that. Like, definitely there is a thing going on. Oh my gosh. What is this guy? No. Oh my god. Never mind. Never mind. Take it. I'm gonna get it. Can get it. Can you bug net? Yeah. Just wanna get the bug out, but nope. As long as it's not fucking on me. Take all the racist attacks and be I'm not sure what you're talking about there. Cornet. But yeah. Soon there will be more and it'll be a new trend. Need a bug net, yeah. I do. A beach ball for my pool. No. Why would I have... Oh, this is a temporary setup and Twitch gets their heads out of their asses. It would be nice. I'm not really counting on it, though. Good night, Lars. Got it. Hi there, Luge Cage. Hi, Pin Dragon. Make that money, you're doing great. I mean, I'm trying here, guys. You guys, any of you guys wanna screenshot and send me under pools, hot tubs, and beaches where I'm at on your recommend, if you're sorting by recommended for you, which is the default sorting recommendation, send me a screenshot of where I'm at. on your device, your computer or phone, you know, all the showing all the people beside me just out of curiosity, you know, the more data I have, the better. But yes, if you did want to help me out, you could do that. Was mean, since you are the first person who is trans doing hop up stream. Yeah. You've followed me on everything, alright, thank you. Appreciate that. At the top, really. I guess who would most be useful from is people who discovered me. Harder thing where, you know, where they discovered me from, where I was on the list as they discovered me, if they'd never seen me before. Which is definitely not getting out of their asses. Like, it'd be nice if they did. When did I start streaming? Very recently. I mean, basically a few months ago, I guess. Never saw myself streaming. All kind of just happened. Because you're following Willow and Nicotine, nice. Incognito. Interesting. Is the water warm? Yes, it absolutely is. A little too warm, some might say. And I told Demon Mama I played Gamster. I definitely am a... Definitely am a gamer. I only have a favorite game. Way too many for just one. A lot of favorite game. As far as like single player series, we're talking like just classic single player series, it would be Mass Effect. Mass Effect series, always love that. Played through that several times now. But as far as like most time spent on games and stuff like that, way different answers. I've spent at least 3,000 hours on Path of Exile. Probably at least 5,000 hours on League, give or take 1,000 or two. And definitely over 10,000 hours on World of Warcraft. Probably over 2013, damn. That's really early. I started playing League in season four. I think. It's either season three or four. And I was a huge TSM fan. Wasn't that the golden era of League? Some might say yes. I mean, I've played it a little bit recently too, and a lot of people say it's gone downhill or all those things. I mean, it was definitely TSM golden era, right? But yeah. I never missed an esports game of League either till like season 7. I watched every single game in season 4, 5, 6. Never missed a game. For all regions too. Like, I was hardcore with the whole esports thing. Hours is 750 days or roughly 2 years. Yeah, JRG. My hunter alone on World of Warcraft, I'll say this, had over 365 days played. Over 365. That's not counting any of my other characters, my time in beta, like any of that stuff. Just my hunter alone had over 365. Yep. Obviously, always goes, pay first if you want something. Never gonna do anything before anyone pays. Just a stupid, stupid request. Do you think that would ever happen? You were a producer for Halo World Championship, which sadly is not nearly as popular. Yeah, League is what got me into esports and all that, and what made me realize it really could be the future. Because how they handled it was how Riot did esports casting and everything with it. It was so well done. So professional, such good casters, just such a good experience in general that made me really see esports as the future. But I haven't really seen many different games or companies or anything that have been able to replicate things like Riot has. I've tried to watch like Hearthstone, because I also was a pretty good Hearthstone player, and I tried to watch like Hearthstone esports and everything, and it was not the same. Couldn't get into it, just even though I liked Hearthstone, just the quality of the stream and everything, and just it wasn't there. Riot did it really well, and that's what made me into it. They made the stakes really high. They made it all the people very likable, all of it, you know. They did a good job. How much is your Steam account worth? Oh gosh. My Steam account probably, I can pull it up. If you guys want to see the number of games I have on my Steam account, it's probably over 4,000. The amount of games and everything I have on here. I have some hidden too. See what we got. 4,000 maybe. Just my Steam points alone, since they added those and everything, I have 13,000. And I never buy anything not on sale either. I only buy things on sale. And I have like 13,000 Steam points saved up, which is 1,300 spent, period. You know, that's just since they added. All right, let's see here. Oh my gosh. Here we go. You can see these are just all these under favorites are currently installed on my main gaming PC.
and these are all the ones that I own in general. There we go. Current Steam library. I have some on Epic Games and Origin too. I believe I own Mass Effect on Origin. I've got like the Kingdom Hearts series on Epic, because they unfortunately weren't on sale on Steam. So yeah, there's other things too than that. And I've also pirated a lot of games. Not so much anymore, but I used to pirate a lot. How do you check what your Steam account is worth? You have more games on Epic than Steam now? Due to all their weekly... Wow. Really? More on Epic than Steam? Like my eyes are pretty cool. Wow, there's a calculator. Let's see.
Welcome back, girly.
Thank you. How do I get to it? I can't find mine on there. Polygon Princess. Thank you. Polygon Princess. And yeah, I know I do have my Steam Euro. Yours is worth 21,000. 21,000, really? Do my Steam Euro? I think I did it in Discord at some point. My profile is public and my library is not hidden, I'm pretty sure. My account is private, really? Oh well, let me see if I can find these settings then. I think it was private. I never make anything private in general. It's like totally. Not typical of me, so. Maybe if I can find this. I don't even see where the options are. I don't even see it in the options. Where it could even be to make it not private. Privacy settings. My profile, public. My basic details, public. Oh, game details. Friends only. Maybe that needs to be public. Friends list, public. Inventory, friends only. Okay. Maybe I just need to turn, like, it's already my profile. Hold on, public. Maybe I just need to turn, like, every little setting to public, I guess. But that's the only thing I can think of, I guess. Cause yeah, everything was already public. You know that I'm running. Everything you wanna do, I already done it. And I got your little boo telling me she love me. I got this one. Damn, it's gonna be a long night. But yeah, now everything absolutely, even the tiniest little details, are public, so. It was already public, I thought, but now it's slightly more public. Your Steam private profile, click edit profile. Yeah, I know, all those things were already public. Oh, show. So, yeah, maybe I do need to sign in to the Steam database. And it says I can sign in through Steam here. So that is probably what I need to do, right? Steam guard. So annoying. Every time I want to fucking sign in, they always want it. Always want it. It's like, come on, I've signed in from this computer 50 times already. Give me a break. It's one thing if it's a totally new computer, but come on. Already done it so many times on here. Okay. Now I'm signed in, so now can you give me a link to it? Yeah, I don't see where it is. Sorry, I'm kind of AFK at the moment. I just got in my car, headed home from the gym. I know I had to set everything to public to get to work originally a long time ago. It's worked since then. Okay. Everything, yeah, is public for me. Yeah, no, that's just, yeah. Last warning, for sure, your own image, everything you're saying, super uncomfortable. That's why I don't address it. Super uncomfortable to me as well as everyone else. So either don't say it or it does. It has to come down to a ban. That's it. Plain and simple. This isn't CB. If you want that shit, go to Chatterbait. You'll get all that you want. Get that out of your system. Come back here. Fine. But not here. Not here. Time and place for everything. So let's see, is my thing able to be? Just curious now. How to find it. Oh wait, there's my account value. Okay, I got it. I got my account value now. Nice. It's, $800 to $2,200. That's what it values my account at, apparently. Sometimes I still feel your touch. When I close my eyes, I do. Cause I know if I give you up. Why does it be gone for good? How does it calculate this? Is it better not, like, I don't know how it values this account. Okay, so my games today are worth 20. 2,200. Which seems low to me. I feel like, you know what I feel like it doesn't include is, it doesn't include DLC or something, because I'm anal, and if I buy something, I have to buy, if I'm gonna buy it, I have to buy every DLC for it, so, yeah. I wonder how much of that is included, because there's no way. Cause I bought most of my stuff like very recently too. So it wouldn't have dropped much. Cause I had a previous Steam account before this. I have another Steam account. This is my one that I made very recently because I got banned. I got banned on Path of Exile because I, for real money trading, because I've always done this. I used to sell things. That was how I made my money. As a kid, I would do it on eBay. I would sell things from gaming back when it was still allowed to make money, to make my living. And so I did that on Path of Exile, and they banned me for selling. At one point I had an account that was like, I was a little cocky in selling it because I was like the best by far in things, and I had one of a kind gear basically, so people noticed that. Basically they noticed that when I was selling it on player auctions and banned me. So I talked to him about it later when I wanted to come back to the game, and they're like, yeah, can't unban you, but you can make a new account. So I was like, all right, making a new Steam account. So I've used that Steam account since my Path of Exile ban. It doesn't track when you buy in-game currency. Yeah, that's true too. Cause I've spent a lot on Path of Exile too. I've spent at least like 150 on Path of Exile. There's probably other things too that I've spent in-game money on and whatnot. Mine only one of them's a little funny. I used to be kind of cocky. I mean, I don't know. Did I say that? No idea. I say that all. That's a phrase that I say. Did I say it just now? It's definitely one of my things. I say it ironically when I talk about being cocky or whatever. I did say that. That is the intense. One of these days, I didn't get a back ban. No, I've never cheated. Like, I've never cheated in the game. Very against cheating, you know? Why does it say 60 out of 92 games played? Like, I have so many more games than 92 on there, you know? Maybe it needs to update here still, because I've got way more on here. 12 or more hours, 20 games. $50 or higher, 8 games. 10 games from $30 to $50. I mean, only 92 games listed though. That's not right. Just some of my favorites. I have 40 on my uncategorized. I have 159. So, I wonder if it doesn't list. I hide a lot of games. I wonder if it doesn't count games that I have hidden, because there's lots of games I've just hidden on there. One of these days, you have to put in the time to figure out how much you put in Fortnite and Warframe. Yeah. You know what game I got suckered into a lot? It was fucking mobile games there for a bit. Never gonna touch mobile games again. Summoner's War. I got a bit into Summoner's War, which actually was... There's a few big streamers that I like know through Summoner's War, because it did spawn a couple of bigger names and stuff, because it's one of the most popular mobile games, especially for streaming, and I got suckered into that way too much for a while. Spent way too much money on there back when I would never do that now. back when I was very... I mean, I didn't spend that much compared to, like, all the people that I was playing with, because I always emphasize the value of skill over money. And I spent probably 300 or 400, though. The people I was playing with, though, they'd spent, like, 20 or 30,000. Those were the people I was playing with. At the level I was playing with, they had spent 20 or 30,000. I'm not kidding here. Like, I got deep into the high level of, like, mobile community and how that goes. And, you know, I felt bad spending, like, 300 or 400. I felt guilty spending that over a few years on a mobile game. But these guys had spent... a lot of them over $20,000, and that was the people I was playing with, and that was just I don't really even know what to say about that, besides it's a very strong statement on how mobile games work. Why the top ones are designed like they are, because there's like a careful line they have to draw, because it has to be accessible enough to allow people or low spenders or anything like that to play the game, these free to play games, because for whales, these people with tons of money to just blow, there has to be enough people around in the game for them to want to spend that money to beat them, right? So, yeah, it's a totally different economy and style of game design, because I do want to be a game developer one day, and looking at it from a game developer's perspective, like, they're not trying to design just the best game. Most entertaining game possible is about, like, just entertaining enough, like, to try and keep, you know, low or no spenders around while being able to heavily incentivize large amounts of spending. Only reward, like, large amounts, and it's a weird world. Gaming's at a weird world, and it is. Having dove into that and seen it firsthand, it's a little scary. There's at least one person I knew who had spent over $300,000. $300,000 on this one game. That is what this person had spent. Like, that is a little... Come on. One person has spent over $300,000 on this game into their account, like, to get things from the game. Like... Shit's crazy. That is fucking nuts. Come on. That is crazy. That these people have it. Most of the ones I knew too, they were Chinese, you know, like, inherited large fortunes. That was most of them, you know, kids of Chinese billionaires, basically, were the ones who were doing this, investing these insane amounts of money into the game. Oh yeah, USD, absolutely. I'm talking USD and everything, but yes. That is. Your best friend spent 3K on Simpsons Tapped Out. Oh my god, yeah. Fuck. 48 on Fortnite in the past year. That's reasonable, though. Especially if you're making... Like, there's a huge difference between spending $500, especially if you make okay money, like, and these people who are spending just tens of thousands of dollars on these games. You gradually spend a little money to have fun, that's all good. But if you get stuck in a money pit, that's not cool. See, the way I look about it, at it, is like, when I spend money on a game now, I try to really, I'm like, I'd like to support the devs. You know, if I buy something, it's like, alright. When I buy something on Path of Exile, which I've done, like, additional, tabs and stuff like that, it's like, well, this game's free to play. They deserve to be supported. It's an awesome game. Path of Exile is an awesome game. If there is a template, like a poster child for how to do free to play correctly, it's Path of Exile. Nothing, no competitive advantage, purely just cosmetic, like those sorts of things to support the developer. And they make it all on that, and that is great for a free-to-play game. You average spending $150 a day on Fortnite over the last year? You've been unemployed for 5 months, Jim. 3 to 4K in Fortnite? Shit, Fuzzy Ones, that's a lot. Your wife gets mad at you, but 100% do stuff to support the devs. It is. Like, you do have to support developers of good games. You know, if you want, I've done that too, like, there's a lot of people who hate it on pirating and all that, but even I used to just pirate all of my games, and then I'd buy the ones that were worth it. You know, if I liked the game, I would buy it. I'm fortunate enough now to have not be a poor college student and all that, and like I can afford to buy games beforehand, so I don't pirate anymore, but like I don't think it's a bad practice. I think there's nothing wrong with pirating and all that, like as long as you are willing. When it comes down to it, if it's something you really, really like and appreciate, support the devs. Give some money, try and keep that sort of content coming. Don't support the assholes, though. Do I ever stream PoE? Yeah. Up until this hot tub streaming became a thing, that was all I was streaming. Every night I was streaming PoE. It's very cynical, Sir Levin. And that really depends on which games you're talking about. Most of the games I play are very indie, small games. That is almost all of what I play. I wouldn't say, like, support League of Legends or support Fortnite or anything like that. They don't need that. Play those games without supporting them, you know what I'm talking about. Actual games that are developed, because that is... If you looked at my library, that is the majority of what my games are. They are from indie, small developers, you know. Support those people. Absolutely. Sure about games. You've read studies that show pirates are the greatest fans. And usually spend more money than non-pirate. Yeah, you're right, Fuzzy Buns. There's so much hand on pirate. It's true for music, too. You know, like, when I was a kid, pirating music and all that stuff, like, that's how I bought my first album. You know, I bought my first album as a kid off something that I pirated. I wanted it on a CD. I wanted more of that, like, as a kid, you know, and that's, like, everything they have ever shown is that pirating basically boosts sales. Music, movies, all that stuff. Because if people like it, they'll pay for it. If it's worth being paid for, if you make a service, a product, any of that stuff that is worth paying for, people will pay for it. And you shouldn't hate on extra exposure, like pirating or whatever, you know, like, that's just bonus exposure. Sure, some people are gonna get it for free. Those people weren't gonna pay for it anyways. They had no intention. They were just curious. They wanted to check it out. They're like, oh, not for me. But there's a lot of people who are like unsure too. And they're like, hey, this actually surprised me. I'm gonna pay for it. Oh, Warframe too. Thank you, Prime. Thanks, Prime. Thank you. Tell that to Metallica, just again. No, fuck Metallica. Fuck Metallica. Alright, you guys want to hear a funny story? It relates, Metallica just reminded me of this. Because this was me as a kid in my early World of Warcraft days. And I've only told this story, I think, once on stream before, so there's probably some of you who've heard it before, but most of you probably haven't, so I'll tell it again. And that is the story of... Alright. I'll try not to spoil it too much, I guess, here, but... I have a pretty entertaining celebrity story and whatnot relating to Metallica and pirating and all this stuff. So, as a kid, yeah, if you can't tell from what I've been talking about, like, I'm a huge fan of pirating. That has changed my life in a lot of ways. It gave me access as a kid to music I didn't have access to in particular. I love Napster. When they were around, you know, they were the OGs, the original, the thing that started it. I had nothing but love and respect for Napster and was a huge fan. And so I was playing World of Warcraft one day and I beat someone in Arena. And this guy raged at me. He raged at me after the arena game, as will often happen. Told me, like, oh, you lucky motherfucker, like, you piece of shit, like, you know, all that. And I was just, I've always been very chill about stuff. It's like, yeah, ha, yeah, you're right, you know, whatevs. And so then he started talking to me and everything, and was very, he realized who I was, because I was kind of a big deal in World of Warcraft, I guess, you know, and he probably looked me up or realized that he wasn't just talking to an average noob here or something. And then we started talking, and I like asked him about his name. His name was Napster. I'm like, why's your name that, you know? And he's like, because I am Sean Fanning, the creator of Napster. And sure enough, he was indeed Sean Fanning, the creator and founder of Napster. And we ended up like being in the same guild, playing together and everything, you know, for a while. It was all kind of crazy because I was such a huge fan, and then to like have to like beat someone unknowingly that I was a huge fan of in a game, and then have him rage at me and end up talking and becoming friends and everything was just all kind of a crazy experience as a kid. But yeah, that's my Napster story, you know, of me and Sean Fanning when he was working on Rupture and all that. I always had, you know, I always fell for him because got everything taken from him. You know, Napster sold for like $90 million to AOL or something back at that time. They auctioned off all their assets. He got nothing. You know, basically left with nothing. And then, you know, his partner, the guy, because they were both Sean. Both their names were Sean. And, you know, the other one who got in on Facebook, Sean, spacing on his name, the one Justin Timberlake played in the Social Network, that's the other Sean. And, you know, he got billions because he got in on Facebook. And the other Sean, though, the one who was actually the brains behind it all, he got nothing. So, yeah. He did, though. He sold Rupture to EA, ended up in, like, 2010 for $10 million, I believe. So he got something. His next project, so that was good. But yeah. There you go. I really have to pee. Oh my gosh, I have to pee. No, I'm not gonna do it in here for you and ass. But here we go. I will be right back. I really have to be in. So be right back. Zanny dog. Okay. Here we go. Back. You used Frostwire. Allegedly less virus filled than LimeWire. I mean, everything after Napster was garbage. They all were. I hated them. None were as good as Napster. Zuckerberg destroys everything in his path. Yeah. Okay. Is stream okay? Never moved to Salt Lake City. Although that is really not far from me. Soulseek is still holding down the fort for EDM. I don't know who they are. Napster was already dead by the time you got into file sharing. Stuck with Soulseek for well over, really? Wow. Yeah, I know Napster, that's how I learned about it. I had no idea it was a thing. One of my friends from school told me about Napster and I was like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. I was downloading off Napster on my like 14.4K modem. As a little kid, I was like, oh my gosh, I have to wait like 10 minutes to get an entire like 2 megabyte song. That was how it went though. And I just anxiously awaited to hear every song. Cause it's not like you have any money as a little kid, right? My parents didn't give me allowance. It's in a poor family. I had no money. No options. So what I could do is download some music on my 14.4K modem. Make faces at Mormons. I mean, I grew up in a small town in Idaho that was all Mormons. I've had enough of the Mormons. There's still plenty of Mormons in Boise, but nothing like it used to be. And I've had my fill of them. Enough of the Mormons. Get internet access until 2005. Wow, that is so late. How could you not have internet access till 2005? Shit. I was a little kid gaming it up on Diablo and like I felt like we got it super late and like I mean we had internet access as a family in like the 90s on AOL, you know, but it wasn't until like 2001, maybe 2002, that we finally had DSL. Because I had been pushing for that forever because I wanted to be able to, you know, talk on, not have people disconnect me by picking up the fucking phone on gaming and just have that constant, always on internet connection, all that, you know. Definitely. But 2005, that's insane. That is insane for it to be that late. Shit, is my stream lagging? Looks like it's crashing. Typical. Fucking typical, right? I need to contact them. Cause losing internet does really fuck me over. Kills my viewers every time. You had a 56k modem in your house. You're not old. I had a 14.4k modem. I know that my parents were hard. I mean, we grew up poor, so it was hard to get them to upgrade too. First game system was N64. Yes. Twice is crashing your internet because they have it out for you, yeah? Fucking aim. Fucking aim. Right. So yeah, I'm glad it didn't fully crash, I guess, but yeah, you guys, alright, tomorrow, I think tomorrow, I might do a Valheim stream. So if any of you guys do want to play on my private server that I have hosted, you should get Valheim. So I think tomorrow that is what I might do. And I'm open to other suggestions too, especially new games that come out, you know, newer games like Valheim and all that, I can play, so definitely into that possibility there. First was an NES, but you eventually traded for a Genesis. NES was way better than Genesis. I like both, but NES had some quality on it. The original Metroid, Zelda, Dragon Warrior, Final Fantasy. Genesis, there's some good stuff. There's like Shining Force 2. There's New Horizons. That was, oh my god, I love New Horizons as a kid. New Horizons. Such a good game. But yeah. Tomorrow, gaming stream, I'm gonna I know you missed out. SNES, I mean, if you really want to argue, the SNES between Genesis, I mean, that's a more fair comparison because those are the same generation of consoles. And SNES versus Genesis, please. SNES kills fucking Genesis. Final Fantasy 3, Super Metroid, Breath of Fire, Super Mario RPG, shit, there's Chrono Trigger, Earthbound, there are just so many, like, hardcore classics off that era, and nowhere near the number you can name off Genesis. Gonna check out Old World. What's Old World? Let me check that out right now. Anything that's new, I'm down for it, you know? Is it new? Is the Old World new? Shit, I don't see it on them. Is it only on Epic Games? I don't know on that one. Towards fast-paced action games, which is where the Genesis thrived. I mean, Super Metroid is a fast-paced action game, and that is arguably, like, the most genre-defining game of all time when it comes to that sort of thing, right? Almost everything has been based on it since. Super Metroid. Amazing game, and that is action. Fast-paced. You really want to say anything on Genesis compared to Super Metroid in that regard? No. Nothing did. Look, I'm not a fucking Nintendo fan either, but I'm just calls them like I see them, Raj. Don't tolerate no nerds. Okay, New World. Let's see here. Okay, this comes out in August. It's an MMO, so immediately no. For Doggin, MMO? No. I will not get involved with an MMO. Never. I'm not that stupid. Something besides that, though, I'm down for, but yeah, no MMOs, please. Anything but that. That's way too consuming. I need games you can pick up and move on from. Not something I'm gonna commit the next 2 years of my life to. Zelda. I don't know about it being fast-paced. It's whatever pace you want to make it. I mean, no, Metroid is fast-paced, yes. Metroid is an action game. You could also give games like Legend of Mana, Secret of Evermore, or Secret of Mana and Secret of Evermore. Legend of Mana was the sequel. But those games are definitely fast-paced, the first action RPGs in the genre. Like, those are different. Genesis didn't have anything like those. Like, you're just looking at total influence overall, like, anything like that. SNES just is miles ahead of Genesis. You never played an MMO, mostly just play old console games on emulator. New system games that we don't have a lot of money, that's fair. But you can download and emulate almost any old games, you know? You can do that. Years, that is light for an MMO. If you have an friend still playing WoW for 17 years, oh my god. Thank goodness I haven't been that fucking trapped, right? Still trying to get a Switch this year, though. The guy I've known from music, born on from years, gave me an old what? Dude, don't get a Switch. Go register, pre-order for a fucking Steam Deck. Steam Deck. Same price as a Switch for the lowest end one, and oh my god, is it so much better. You have access to all your Steam library, don't need to buy new games. Like, in general, anything, I will always, always, always support anything that is just open source, freedom, that sort of stuff, over anything that is controlling and says, hey, you gotta go by these rules. Like, you can't even get Netflix on a Switch without jailbreaking it, breaking everything. Like, any platform should always support the platform that is more, that's why Apple is the devil. Should never own an Apple product. They're fucking garbage. Anyone who wants to control things at that level, they are directly standing in the way of human progress, and they are garbage as companies. And I will never ever ever pay for a Nintendo product. Like, I'm talking about games that were on systems, you know, like they were the best games, and I'll support that SNES was better than Genesis, all that stuff, but never buy a Nintendo product, because any company that's like that is garbage. They're standing in the way of human progress, technological progress, all that. If you want to have a handheld, you want that, get a Steam Deck. That is the better alternative. They are willing to allow you to install whatever OS you want on it. No jailbreaking necessary. You know, it's more powerful in every aspect by miles. It's just, it's better in every way imaginable. But somehow, some people will still buy Switches because God knows why. They're very confused. Individuals, don't be one of those. I'm right here, I'm informing you and telling you, don't do that stupid shit. Be a little bit smarter. Buy the better alternative. Support the world and the future. Don't support that bullshit. I mean, and there's nothing wrong with how, you know, I'm not like trying to diss on anyone who's ever bought a Switch or anything like that. The guy I dated, he owns a Switch. I considered buying a Switch at points, but the fact that there's now a viable alternative if you want a portable system don't buy a fucking Switch. Now there's no excuse. Anyone who buys a Switch at this point, with there being viable alternatives, no. You've lost your excuse there. Before that, it's fine. You want something mobile, there's nothing else. They've got a monopoly. It's what you have to do. You have to cow to the fucking dictator, the monopoly's will of bullshit, right? That's what you have to do, but now, you've been informed, you don't need to do that anymore. Can you play Nintendo games on it? Absolutely, you can. You can play anything that is available anywhere. You can emulate, you can do whatever. You can play ROMs on it. It's just a computer. It's a handheld computer. You can play anything that you want on it. This is why Steam is so much, why what they're doing is so much better. You can't just play Steam games on it. Play Epic games on it. Play Origin games on it. You can play whatever you want on it, even with the default OS. You can install whatever OS you want on it. You can if you really wanted to be a dumbass, I guess, you could install Nintendo Switch OS on it and just be locked into the Nintendo Switch games with way better like, if that's really what you wanted to do, you could do that. You know, I wouldn't recommend it. That's stupid, because then all you can do is pay overpriced values for their incredibly limited selection of games that they have on the Switch compared to other platforms. You could do it, though. That's really what you wanted, but wouldn't you rather have access to everything at a much lower price? So yeah. Oh, of course Switch games would run better on the Steam Deck. Oh my god, they would run better. Like, you look at the actual specs between the two. Steam is making this product at a huge loss. Like, from most, like, it's well known that the Switch is the only product that sells at a profit as far as console gaming goes. Everything else, like the Xbox, PlayStation, all that stuff, always sold at significant losses. They sell it at losses because they make the money back in games. Through game sales, Switch sells at a profit, and that's because the specs are garbage on it. They are so low. Everything that you want to do on a Switch, if you just want to install the Nintendo OS, like do all that stuff, it'll run 1,000 times better because the specs on that are 10 times of what the Switch is. They dwarf it. They would absolutely run better, even not fully optimized for the thing. They're still gonna run better. So that's just my little spiel, I guess. I'm very against companies in general, anyone who says, you can't do this. You have to use our OS, you have to use our stores, you have to use our programs, like, fuck that shit. I'm an adult. I get to decide what I want to use. You don't get to fucking tell me what I get to use. And time for people to start recognizing that. Stop putting up with the bullshit. Because fuck that. Fuck Apple. Fuck Nintendo. Fuck those companies that want to tell you every little thing that you have to do and control every tiny little aspect of it. Nah. Fuck that. Being informed, fucking adult, and say no. There are other options. Like, sadly, until just now, until the Steam Deck, there weren't other options for a mobile gaming system, and like, that's why I couldn't fault anyone for having a Switch or anything. There weren't other options. There was nothing out there. The PS Vita was discontinued so long ago. Like, there were no other options. Can't fault you, you know? Like, that's a market. There's validity to wanting that item. But now there's no excuse. No excuse. It's there. There's an actual competitor. Support that. Support the company that is going for freedom and progress rather than the company that's going for iron fucking will. Nothing but us has to be this way. Like, that's, you know, if everyone does that, you know where we end up in 50, 100 years? We're just in a fucking scary world. Scary dictatorship of companies. Like, don't support those companies. Can you see the future? Can you see where that's going? Not a good place. When given the opportunity, always take the company that is going to at least be more, like, it's a lesser of two evils thing, you know? I'm not, like, saying, like, oh, Steam's so great, all these things. Like, it's always a lesser of two evils, but at the very least, take the lesser of the two evils. If you want us to survive, if you want your kids to have any sort of future, if you want any of that, then just at least take the very least you can do as a person on this planet is just take the lesser of the two evils. It's not a big ask either. Just the lesser of the two evils. I'm not asking you to significantly change your life, go out, do all these things. Just when you're given the choice of two products, take the one that's less fucked up than the other one for the long-term prospects of humanity. Is that really such a big ask? Apparently, because people are still buying Apple. You know? They're still doing this shit. So, all I can do is just be very passionate and say my point on it. At least, you know, at least I can sleep easy at night on that, you know? I've done what I can. What more can I do than this? My passionate speech about it, you know? It's not me. I've never owned a Apple product. I've never owned a Nintendo product post, you know, post N64. So, I've done my part. I've done what I can. That's why you're moving away from Apple computers, even for your professional work. Yeah, you should. You like paying premium price for a name brand that garden walls my existence. Nice, fuzzy buns. That totally fucking describes Apple right there more than anything. You're like, it also describes Nintendo though, too, really. Like, Nintendo isn't as bad as Apple, I'm not trying to say that, but they're still bad. They're still on that track. If they had more power and influence, they would be Apple. They would love to be Apple, you know? How about somebody who just steals the Switch from Abby? Yeah. Hi there, Steph. You don't own anything by Apple except iTunes. Sure as heck didn't pay for it. That's good. You'll still buy Apple, but it's because their products are optimized better. Or wildly supportive, no ethical conception under cap. I mean, so not true. None of that is true. That is 100%. You've fallen into the lies. And like at that point, if you bought into all the lies, the propaganda, the nonsense, I don't have anything to say. Cause you're lost. You're one of those lost souls, you know. Nothing's ever gonna convince you. Doesn't matter. Some people, they're gonna do what they're gonna do. My parents, they all buy Apple. You know, I don't try to convince them. They're lost. They're beyond hope. I know what they're gonna do. They're gonna buy Apple products. And that's because it's too hard. They think they're convinced of these lies. It's too hard to learn something new, all this, you know. It's fine. The most I can hope for is, though, as old people die off, Apple will die off. That's the most best I can hope for. Am I kidding? Nintendo is way worse than Apple? No. Nintendo is not worse than Apple because Apple is a 20 times larger company. Nintendo is like what? Maybe they're like 10, 15 times. Apple's what? Like 1.5, 2 billion or 2 trillion-ish, and you know. Nintendo is 100 to 200 billion-ish. But regardless, you know, many, many times larger, and so Apple inherently is going to be allowed more evil because of their size and influence and all that. Way more evil. You have a 12 mini, but only because you always have problems with Android. It's been working. I don't know what a 12 mini is, but yeah. Oh, iPhone 12 mini. See, that's, I mean, I guess that's the problem is that Android requires you basically to be a little bit tech savvy in that, hey, there's a lot of products out there. I have to look through them all. I have to actually make an informed decision as a buyer. And like, that's what people like about Apple, but it's also the fucking problem is that, sure, you don't have to do any decisions. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to test. Just buy the next Apple product, and it'll be just as mediocre and underwhelming as the previous one, but just good enough, just simplistic enough to keep you buying them. Just, you know, designed to fail soon enough, all those things, just enough to keep you buying them. And like, sure, if you compare an Apple product to a poor choice in the market, there's plenty of shitty Android products out there. But it's your fault for buying them. There's plenty of really great ones out there too. And it's like everyone, it's ironic though. I feel like everyone who support an Apple or all that, they're also like all about like capitalism and free market and all that. It's like, no. Totally off the mark, Garrow. Yeah. You don't trust Google at all in Android OS products or dog, please. Almost every test that I've ever seen of an actual comparably priced Android product versus an Apple product, the Android will always outperform. So I really, if you want to show me actual facts or whatever on that, even if you say, all right, somehow they're better because Apple has full control. That's what they have. No hardware developers can develop anything. They've got full control. You can't get parts replaced if you want them, you know, like all that. They're just gonna have maximum control, total dictatorship over everything, zero open source. You can't change anything. Even if you wanna say, all right, it performs better. Is that worth it? Is that cost worth it? Even then, if it's, you know, to me it's not. I would never, ever, ever sacrifice that for, at best, slightly better performance, but in reality, not better. If you actually know what you're looking for and get the right devices, like, not better. Absolutely not. But just, are you really willing to sacrifice that? God, no. Like, I feel very passionate about this. I would rather fucking kill myself than ever support Apple, like, ever. I think they are goddamn devil. They are the downfall. If there's a downfall to humanity, it's Apple. Almost guarantee you there's a lot of people who get caught up in a lot of things, but if how humanity is going down in flames 20, 30, 40, 50 years from the future, it's Apple. Guarantee it. Bet my life on that. That is devil company. Google, Microsoft, all that shit, they've got problems. They've got fucked up shit, Amazon, you know, privacy issues, tons of fucking issues. You actually compare that to Apple and what they're doing, the kind of just total dictatorship around tech and production and what people can or can't have on their, you compare that, it's nothing. It's fucking nothing. That is the fucking devil. I mean, I've got a Pixel right here. My phone before this. I had a Pixel 2 before this. Got a Pixel 4 5G right now. Love it. Nothing wrong with it. For that also, I prefer Windows Phone. Windows Phone was so much better than Android. They ended, sadly, but I had a Windows Phone forever, and they were so much better, but still, doesn't even matter. Wow. Why would I have iTunes? What's the point of having iTunes? There's all these other services out there that are far superior. Fuck iTunes. iPhone performs better, that's why I use it. Make calls and send cat pictures way faster. I mean, look, obviously I know people are gonna use their fucking Apple products. They're gonna buy them. My brother uses it. My family in their entirety almost use it, and I'm just telling you, no matter what your excuse is, you're wrong. That is my opinion. You can excuse it all you want, but it's wrong. Because I think it's horrible for humanity in the long term. And you know, I'm not, it's not a topic I'm gonna hasn't come up before, I haven't really discussed this ever before. It's something I feel passionate about, obviously. Strong feelings, but when it comes down to it, people are gonna do what they're gonna do. And I'm not gonna hate you or anything for it. If you choose to have an Apple product to do that, I never will. And the best I can do is just tell you why I never will and never have, and explain my reasons why. And if you still choose to have an Apple product, you go for it. You can believe whatever you want to believe. I've done my research. I've spent countless, like, huge amount of times discussing this, thinking about it, all that stuff. And as a developer, a programmer, any of that stuff, like anyone in that industry will probably tell you just how fucking horrible Apple is. And like, I don't expect the average person, I guess, to really understand what it is if you aren't in that sort of involved in that industry at all or anything like that. And it's fine. It is what it is. The least I can do though is state my opinion and try to inform people. They don't want to listen. They don't want to believe it. They want to keep using Apple products. Go for it. I'm not going to hate you. I think we're all people. We're all just doing the best we can, making the best decisions we can with the information and whatnot that we have, and it is what it is, right? I'm not gonna hate you for it. I mean, yeah, sure, Microsoft isn't a great company either. Again, as I was saying, lesser of two evils. It's still fucked. But I feel like as a citizen of this earth, that's the least I can do. Is at least choose the lesser of two evils. We have to be parts of society. We have to accept that some shit is the way it is. We can't change everything. It's out of our control. But what I can do as an average person is just try, when given the option, take the lesser of two evils. That's what I can do. The iPhone for cat pictures was sarcastic. Basically, most phone users don't ever get near to using max performance. It's absolutely right. Fuzzy Buns is like, all the shit people worry about or whatever, it's all ridiculous. They justify things in whatever ways they can. Their reasons for doing things, and like, I'm not gonna fault anyone for doing that. Justify your actions whatever ways you want. We all do it. I do it. Everyone does it. We rationalize. We do all that shit. And the least I can do as a person, though, I feel, is just at least provide a counter viewpoint there, an alternative perspective, and that is that don't fucking buy Apple. No matter what. You know, that is it. That reasoning was why I voted for Hillary in 16, Biden in 20, but I'm not, I mean, yeah, I'm with you there, boop. I mean, I'd rather. Yeah. Not great options, but they're better options than what was given to it. The other choices, right? They're obviously still better options. Hillary still obviously was a better option than Trump, and Trump was, like, obviously a worse option than Biden. They all suck, but at least some are better than the others. And that's the least we can do as humans, is take that, like, slightly less shitty thing. If you care about the future or anything, you should take that slightly less shitty thing for the future, regardless of what it costs you. You love your Windows phone, that's why you went into iPhone. Yeah, it's fine. I'm not American, but I wouldn't vote for either. I wouldn't either if I didn't have to. Like, as a trans person, you really don't have much of a choice either. You're given, no matter what, you're given pretty much the choice of, like, oh, regardless of what I think of a person or whatever, I can vote Democrat, or I can just actively vote against my own interests and, you know, basically hate coming towards me, removing my rights, all that. That is, you know, because, like, I'd love to be, there's a lot on the right I agree with, actually. I'm more of a moderate, but because of the fact that they are just shitty towards trans people, it gives me no choice. No trans person, no self-respecting trans person has any choice but to be on the left. You know, because what, you're just gonna actively vote against, like, yourself to vote for these people who are just actively repressing you, who are putting laws out there at every chance they get to invalidate your very existence? No. You're given no choice. You like South Park's episode on choices, giant douche for church sandwich? I'm with you there. I love South Park. Always, Matt Stone and Trey Parker, damn. Trey Parker was always, like, my celebrity crush as a kid and stuff, you know? Can't get past a lot of the preachy libertarian bullshit on that show. I disagree. But maybe I am kind of... I'm kind of libertarian myself. A little. More. I'd say I'm more leaning towards democratic socialist, which is basically a form of anarchist. And, you know, I'd rather just all wealth be eliminated, basically, and also all central control. In a way, it's like if you've ever watched the show Mr. Robot, the core values in Mr. Robot are essentially close to how I feel. The creator of that was also a democratic socialist / anarchist. You'd rather vote for the worst Democrat than the best Republican. Yeah, that's basically how it boils down. Right there, like, that's the choice I'm given. It doesn't even really matter how much I like them or anything, but, like, when it comes down to it, if I'm voting for a Republican, I'm at risk of giving up my own rights. As a trans, like, there are serious ongoing battles still. Like, people were only briefly, here in Idaho, allowed to change their birth certificates. They repassed a law, so again, they can't. Like, these are serious issues that are really, really affecting trans people today. Like, it's not an easy process to go through to get your name changed and all that. And, like, the fact that you're preventing that on birth certificates, again, after the Supreme Court ruled. And that's because Republicans here decided to pass a law, like, in direct contradiction of a Supreme Court ruling, because they just wanted to, even though they're going to spend millions of dollars fighting it in court and it's going to be struck down. Without a doubt, it's going to happen. They're doing that, though, because they just hate trans people that much. They want to fuck them over that much. And, like, that's where we're at. That is where we're at here. And, like, that doesn't leave us any choice. How could I possibly vote for someone who's gonna do that, regardless of what any of their other beliefs, platforms, anything are? If they're gonna do that, I can't vote for you because you're a garbage human being. You're garbage. That's it. Doesn't matter if you have some other opinions, if you're really just willing, like, that willing to fuck over people, support that, like, fuck you. Fuck you. Can't support you. I can look past a lot, I can't look past that. Thank you, Yarrow Flower. Appreciate that. Area. Thank you. You timed out yourself with a bit. Nice. That's awesome. Yep, your name went on the board. You mean American libertarian, which is like conservatism with a few perks, is like being pro-weed. Left libertarianism, you're down with, but that's a different thing. Yes, they're very different things. There's like definitely different forms of libertarianism, and like, I'm on the left libertarian side. Because I think all drugs should be legalized. The very least, decriminalized. We don't need prison systems. We don't need, like, there's a lot. I think that can just fucking go. You're trans and you've lived in the Bible, felt all your life. Tell me about it. Yeah, no, I did too. I grew up in Indiana and then southern Indiana, like on the border of Kentucky. And then when I was young, I moved to a small, all Mormon town in southern Idaho. All Mormon. One of the very few non-Mormons there, so yeah. Have I heard that they're working a pass bill that'll allow you to be a they, them on their passport? That is pretty cool. That definitely needs to happen. Gender neutral passports, that'd be a totally good thing for a lot of people. Cause the last, like, who's it gonna harm? Who is that gonna harm? No one. Who's it gonna help? It's potentially going to prevent a lot of trans violence. People going into countries that are, you know, anti-trans, more conservative, any of that. Like, preventing them from getting murdered or just anxiety or whatever. But, like, it's not gonna hurt anyone. So who is against this sort of thing? Who's it gonna hurt? No one. Who's gonna help? A lot of people. And that's the problem, because the right is against things like that. The hard right, they are against stuff like that. And that's why it makes it very, very hard to support them. They're willing to just, you know, come out against things that are, like, don't hurt anyone. Rule, like, new things that would harm no one and only help people, and they're still against them. Just because they're trying to stick to their hardcore Bible beliefs or whatever bullshit reasoning they want to come up with, which they always do, nonsense, like crazy scenarios, that's what they'll use too. They'll use like hyperbolic, one time this happened, we had to have our researchers looking for days, we found this one fucking case. And this one isolated scenario where this one thing happened and this very, like, specific thing. We found this person. We did. And this happened. And, like, we're going to use that as our platform against absolutely everything. And there's people that are stupid enough to believe that and feel like that is the reality. When it's not. It's hyperbole. They've taken one fucking example that they struggled to find. And they're using that as a way to portray it as if it's much more widespread. This is like a serious thing. Oh my gosh, it's the downfall of America. If whatever happens. And that is how it goes. You're a Hoosier too, Killer Queen? Really? Yeah, I know, I'm a Hoosier. Got an Indiana birth certificate. All my family is back in Indiana, actually. I go back there pretty regularly. I was born in Terre Haute. Most of my family is up more northern Indiana though, in Rensselaer, near Lafayette. You're from Northeast Indiana. Yeah, that's where I would always visit. Rensselaer. Up there by Lafayette. Where most of my family's from. You live in West Tennessee. Memphis has a great LGBT community. I have heard that with Tennessee actually being in one of the better places to live, like Nashville. I've heard a lot about Nashville being a good place for younger people and all that. I don't know necessarily about Memphis, but I assume it's probably similar. They don't commit to any stand that they take. They often contradict their own points. How can you support someone who doesn't believe the things they say? Yeah, I'm with you there, Prime. Just to play devil's advocate, I'll say I'm a religious corporate conservative Republican, yeah. Mr. Robot is on Prime Video. That's one of my favorite shows. I love Mr. Robot. That show espouses a lot of my general feelings and opinions on things pretty well. It's a great show. I was surprised, honestly, that they ever let it air on USA because it's just so fucking anti-capitalism, anti-control, all that. And yet, somehow they did let it air mainstream, which is great. There's no LGBT plus community in your hometown. Yeah. That, my hometown, there definitely was not either. Idaho Falls? Oh god, no. Not where I went to junior high and high school. Zero LGBT community. There's no one even gay there. You know? No one I knew. No, not a single gay person in my high school, because those people would just be fucking demolished. They, like, yeah, literally not even one. There was one kid who was, he was obviously pretty gay, and he just got bullied to fucking hell. Jamie, he talked to me later, too, about it all. He found me on, like, Facebook or something after I'd come out. You know, everyone knew there. It was, like, a whole gossip story, so I had a lot of people come to me about things after I came out, because it was, like, a huge story there in my hometown. Like, the trans person, you know? So, I had a lot of people talk to me after, and, yeah. No one would have dared have been gay in my town. Not till later. Everyone you know from high school had to come out way, way after high school, yeah. That's how it went, basically. Have I watched Star Trek The Next Generation? I have not actually watched that. But you were picked on a lot as a kid. Your only friends were the minorities who were picked on for how they look or how they are. Always stand for quality. That's good. Not that you were picked on, but doing that, I mean, yeah. I always tended to associate more with the outer layers of society or whatever. Fringe, because I never really found groups that I could fit into very well from my school. Not my thing. You tell people to start a season. Okay, that's good to know. If I ever watch it, season two. Okay. Have things changed in your hometown since you were in school? No. They haven't changed. Sadly, still pretty bad there. They have gotten a little better. They're not as bad as they were, but if you told me there was like someone openly trans or even openly gay there in school, I would be shocked. Cause that really, really does not happen. And I know a lot of younger people in there through friends and their like younger sibling, all that sort of stuff. And like it's all Mormon. Mormons really, really, really hate on that stuff. They really hate gay and trans people. There's not much there. The losers, the outcasts, the weirders, the freaks and gates, the theater kids, the kids who are just bitchy different. Is that like My Chemical Romance right there? Did you just quote some My Chemical Romance? I'm not even sure if that was or not. If that was like the beginning to I'm Not Okay. It was close though, right? I feel like that's pretty close to the beginning of I'm Not Okay. You're autistic in elementary school is a nightmare for you. They didn't know what to do with me. They did this thing where half the day do regular classes, an hour or two in special ed. I feel like you fit in either way, yeah. I can see them. Oh wow. Boo. Poopadoo. This name is gonna be, thank you. Thanks, Yara. And let's see if I can do this. See if I can do this name. Boo Poopadoo. It's quite the name. Long one. I've gotta fit it up here. Boo. Poop. Do. There we go. Long name. Thank you. Okay, Yara, it was just a generally edgy teen monologue. It was close to My Chemical Romance, right there. You dropped out after third grade and your grandma got you into homeschooling because she had to work a lot. That didn't really work out. Education is a tough one. My friend, who I want to have on, maybe Friday, maybe a bit later, we'll see. She's a special education teacher, actually, who works in the resource room, which is like, she's the head of the resource room there, and she's like she works a lot with the kids all the kids she works with are in and out of classes. They're like the borderline ones. She's the one who evaluates them and works with them and tries to get them back in, so. I've heard she was my best friend forever, and I'm very aware of a lot of things that go on there in elementary school, young kids, because she works with the young kids. She's like the first line, you know, the kindergarten through fourth grade stage, and I've heard a lot about it, and there's a lot that's very fucked up, and she has a lot of opinions on what's wrong with our education system in general, and there's a lot that's fucked up, a lot that we could be doing better. Uriah is Betty Boop's catchphrase. Where can you buy a hot tub and how much does it cost? This was $7.50. I got it off Target. Target.com. You're autistic too in school. I'm also neurodivergent / autistic, high on the spectrum, but yeah. I'm thinking of the Streetlight Manifesto song. I love Streetlight Manifesto / Catch 22, A Moment of Silence, but that isn't what I'm thinking of. I am thinking of My Chemical Romance. I am thinking of them. Let's watch it, shall we? Just a little bit, the intro, we can decide.
You like D&D, Audrey Hepburn.
All right, here it was. We heard him a little bit right there, right? It's not quite the same.
And Fangoria, Harry Houdini, and Croquet. You can't swim, you can't dance, and you don't know karate. Face it, you're never gonna make it.
Area. That was basically it though. What I was thinking of. But also same vibe. Yeah, I know, it's like the vibe I was talking about right there is like, you know, the general like rejection vibe or whatever, that sort of stuff. You kind of want to have to strike a brand deal with Target, yeah. Okay. So. Okay. Let me see here. Who we got. I need... Someone trans. Here we go. Perfect. Willow's online. I've not rated Willow since. I've never ended before Willow ended, and that's because usually I'm on like way later. And that's because I started far earlier tonight than I normally do with my interview and all that. So, I will go with Willow. Right, guys? I can finally pay back Willow for having rated me. Never happens. So, yes. Thanks, guys, for for everyone. Everyone who came by, appreciate it. And let's raid Willow and say hello. Stream's a little behind, we'll see. Let's go, guys. Click OK. Alright, good night, guys. Thank you all for coming by. Appreciate it. Last chance, you want to get a part? Here we go.